All HTML elements can be made into HTML server controls. To do this, we place them inside a form control and include the runAtServer attribute. The element now becomes an HTML control that we can manipulate using its ID reference. The control in this case is of the HTML anchor class. For this class, we can for example set the href and title properties, both of which correspond to the attributes with the same names. For attributes that don't have a property, we can add them to the attribute collection as a name-value pair. Another way to create HTML controls is using only code. To demonstrate, let's add an image inside a link from the page load method in the code page. We find all the HTML controls under the system web UI namespace, but since this namespace is already included with the using directive, we don't need to write the full path in order to create our image. We then set the source and border properties and add the image to the anchor's control collection. If we now run the page, the image will show up inside the anchor element. Now, if we wanted to add an element that didn't have its own HTML control, we would instead use the HTML generic control class. This class can hold any HTML control and therefore represent any HTML element. For example, to create a break tag, we add the tag to the constructor for that object. Alternatively, we can just as well use the tag name property once the object has been created. We then add a control to the form, this time using the addAt method to place it before the anchor control. Viewing the page now shows that the break is indeed added before the link.